Итак, давайте начнем. Первый вопрос. Почему вы убрали таблицу очков в конце игры?
That's actually my doing, so you can blame me.
Oh my god, I blame you.
The big reason was we wanted the focus to be on more about the team than anything else. We found that a lot of people were kind of using the scoreboard as their primary goal in the match. There's a lot of people that would, I'm top of the scoreboard, somebody else should change. I'm going to continue playing offensive Widowmaker because I'm top of the scoreboard. And ultimately, everything in the game is always driving towards team-based action and not necessarily individual scores. You should have a good idea of how well you're doing with the medals on the bottom or a fire effect around your portrait. So you should have that feedback, but we're not doing individual stack ranking for personal gain, essentially.
То есть этого больше не будет?
It is not intended to come back.
Понятно. Давайте вернемся к началу разработки игры. Что вдохновляло вас при создании дизайна Overwatch? Существовали ли какие-нибудь другие варианты концепции дизайна? Может быть, в более футуристичном стиле?
The style. Oh, my phone's buzzing. Sorry. Sorry about that. The design of the heroes. It was not definitely done. Not done like all in the very beginning. It was more of a process. As we've developed the game, we look at what the game's lacking and we decide to add a hero. And that hero can come from, hey, there's a group of abilities we really want to see in the game that we feel like will make the game a little bit more balanced. Or there's a really cool character that we want to gain. But the world has evolved as well as the gameplay at the same time. It's kind of been hand in hand the whole way. So there was no kind of master idea. We had some really good ideas and we're kind of just planting the seeds and letting it grow organically.
Давайте поговорим о респаунах. Во многих играх этого жанра волновой респаун, когда игрок возвращается сразу. В Overwatch сейчас нужно ждать 13 секунд. Мы заметили, что некоторым игрокам это не очень понравилось. Вы не могли бы рассказать, почему была выбрана именно эта система, а не другая?
I think a lot of it has to do with the player abilities. We want to let those things shine. We have Symmetra with her teleporter and we have Lucio with the run. The respawn's relatively quick right now, and we like to kill cam. We feel like you get a lot of information out of it, and being able to digest that, as opposed to having that finite time of just like after 6 or 7 seconds, you're kind of back in the game. And man, I really appreciate that teleporter that's being there. I'm glad Lucio. I'm spawned with Lucio, and now we're back in the action. It was more about that, letting you have the chance to understand the kill cam and respawn and play up the hero abilities a little bit more.
Вместе с Origin Edition мы получим еще 5 новых скинов для героев. Можете ли вы сказать, когда нам ожидать еще больше скинов?
That's a good question. We didn't know that yet. The big thing for us is, as soon as we announced Overwatch, everybody was like, "Wow, when can I get skins?" And now we have skins. We think skins are super cool. We enjoy doing it. It's really interesting with the Origin skins because we don't have a traditional narrative in the game and those origin skins. I mean, we literally unmasked the Reaper yesterday. So it has an opportunity to tell the story, and we like that aspect of it. They're definitely cool, and we like the idea of skins.
Blizzard говорили, что Overwatch будет не единственной игрой по этой вселенной. Вы можете рассказать, игры каких жанров планируется представить с героями и картами из Overwatch?
Yeah, I mean, we look at Overwatch as the first step of the universe. We think it's a really cool universe, and we're watching it grow. I don't know if you guys caught the panel today. There's a lot of the new shorts that are coming out, some of the graphic novels and everything. We think the world could support multiple games. Right now, we're just focused on this one.
Сейчас в бете присутствуют игроки совершенно разных уровней. В нее играют как новички жанра FPS, так и профессионалы. Учитывая этот факт, расскажите немного о балансе. К примеру, Макри может плохо зайти на низком уровне, а на высоком уровне игры он очень опасен. Как Blizzard собирается следить за этим? Будете ли вы обращать внимание на то, каким должен быть герой? Простым для новичков или больше ориентированным на про уровень, например, как в StarCraft 2?
Sure. We're definitely, like Bastion's another good example. He completely destroys people at lower levels, and higher levels it's a little bit different. We are I mean, we're looking at balance right now. We have an upcoming balance change that we're going to do, I think coming up pretty soon. We're taking into some of that the account of some of the heroes that may be considered overpowered in the beta right now. It's not about, I think with a bigger population as well, I think that some of the lower level players they won't get stomped as much by some of the pro teams. Ultimately, we're looking at Bastion. I think Bastion's one of the bigger, kind of the bigger outliers. He's probably the one. Him and Torbjorn, they're the two biggest challenges because at low levels they crush, high levels they're hardly played. So we're actually looking at those guys. We're actually trying to find that middle ground between. We want to make everybody viable at all levels. I mean, that's really, really, really the goal.
Может все-таки не Торбьорн? Его трели такие гадские.
Yeah, at low levels people can't get past them, but at high levels you can barely keep one up. You know, there's lots of ways around that stuff.
Лучший игрок матча получает очки после игры. Не знаю, как это называется. В общем, вы можете голосовать за игрока, который вам больше всего понравился. Вы не видите проблем в том, что игрок матча получает очки именно таким способом?
Well, two things. I think there's two things on that. The first one is we're still working on the play of the game. We think that support heroes are super underrepresented in it. Like, you could have, like, sometimes they make the play of the game, you know, as you play, but they're not represented in that. We're definitely looking at that stuff. Usually there's some, we're looking at different card faces that we can do. We have ideas out there of what if there was a play of the game card or something like that. We have a bunch of different ideas that we want to try in that card space. Ultimately, that card thing is just, the card screen is meant to show a story of what happened in that game. Oh wow, that Symmetra had a 75% teleporter uptime and teleported 25 people. That's probably why we lost, because we couldn't take out that teleporter. As opposed to, oh, Symmetra was top of the scoreboard. It's trying to get a little bit more details into the story of the match, the narrative of the match.
У нас была возможность поиграть в Overwatch в игровой зоне внизу, и мы заметили, что герои получают опыт за сыгранные матчи. Можете пояснить, как это будет работать в будущем?
Yeah. So it's interesting. We have we want a progression system in Overwatch. Like that's our goal. We set it from kind of the very beginning. We were on our second iteration of the progression system. We had a first one where we actually had like talents in there, which like Reaper could heal when he Wraith formed automatically. It was like when you were fighting against Reaper, you didn't know which Reaper you were fighting against. We felt like it wasn't Overwatch. You need to know the combat clarity of this is Reaper and this is how I need to deal with him. the version that's kind of downstairs, we actually pulled that progression system. It actually was pretty much done, or at least for beta. It was beta ready, and we yanked it 2 days before beta because we found in our internal playtest that it was promoting the wrong behavior. It was hero-centric, which means I want to level Widowmaker for whatever reason, whatever your motivation is, whether it's just to get... At the time, we had nice portrait borders and stuff like that. Like, you just wanted to move your hero up that level, which totally competed with the assemble your team's phase and, oh, you have too many snipers. Well, they're all trying to level up to level 10 or whatever it is. So it just was completely counter to the team-based thing. So we pulled it. We want to put the focus different. We have some ideas. We're pretty confident in them, and we think it's going to be cool when it gets in there. We hope to have it in beta at some point.
Недавно было объявлено, что Overwatch выйдет и на консолях. И нам стало интересно, как вы будете работать над балансом игроков на консолях и ПК. Например, Вдова может быть очень сильна на ПК, потому что у игрока есть мышь. А на консоли она, скорее всего, будет слабее, потому что вы играете с геймпадом.
We hope to keep them at like 1-to-1, and so far we play every day on the consoles. We think it plays super, super good. Like we love playing on it, and we haven't had to adjust much. I mean, the traditional console stuff that you have to do with the mapping of the controls and making sure that all works, but gameplay wise there's virtually no difference between the two.
Ранее разработчики говорили, что добавление новых героев для них в большем приоритете, чем добавление новых карт. Однако выбор тех или иных героев сильно зависит от карты, а также от того, нападает или защищается команда. Планируется ли добавление новых игровых режимов, где обе команды могут или нападать, или защищаться?
Oh, in terms of game modes, we've prototyped so many. Like we had a prototype of Capture the Flag at some point in there, which was nothing. Everybody was Tracer. Like, it turned into something that was very, very not Overwatch. You know, it wasn't really clicking. We are always prototyping new game modes. We're super open to it. But the most important thing is when we find something that still has the values of what Overwatch is, which is team versus team, core combat, in a space that's more of a playground and less of, you know, doesn't really force the game mode as much. It's all about the heroes, you know what I mean? So as long as it has those core values, we'll like it. But we're experimenting and prototyping lots of different things.
Рассматриваете ли вы идею создания в Overwatch подобие режима потасовки, как в Hearthstone, с какими-нибудь глупыми правилами или картами, где, например, все должны играть одним и тем же героем, или где будут определенные задания, что-то с набором интересных правил, но не связанные с самой игрой?
Yeah, I think there's we don't have anything specific with that, but I think there's that private game match allows you to do that stuff, at least, you know. You know, with gentleman rules, essentially, like, okay, well, let's try it, and you can experiment as much as you want. We're open to tons of stuff. We love experimenting and trying some of that things. We see crazy compositions, the all six bastions versus the all. You know what I mean? Like, we think they're a lot of fun, but there's no specific plans right now to do something like that.
Еще один короткий вопрос: связаны ли консоли и Battle.net? Я могу играть на PlayStation 4 с другом, который играет на ПК.
No, there's no cross-platform play.
Это печально.
Kills.
Многие спрашивают, как скоро появится соревновательный режим в Overwatch. Например, режим турниров или режим игры на ранг. Расскажите поподробнее о соревновательном аспекте в игре.
Yeah, I think there's two aspects to it, and both systems, we don't have anything to get into details on, but we definitely think a rank system would work beautifully in Overwatch, and there's the other route, which is the esports route, and you can see some of that stuff is planted as the observer mode in the private match right now. We're working on ways to make Overwatch extremely watchable from a PvP standpoint, but yeah, we love all the competitive modes, rank play and esports.
Во время презентации мы увидели довольно интересную статистику. Например, сейчас у Симметры самые большие шансы выиграть. Один мой друг будет просто счастлив от этого. Есть ли еще какие-то статистические данные, которые всплыли в бете и которые вы не ожидали увидеть?
A little bit more subdued. I mean, there's some really aggressive Symmetras out there that can be awesome, but her teleporter is so key, and the way that she can defend and set stuff up, and her shields are amazing. Like, if the other team doesn't have shields and you have 50 more health that regenerates each time, I think it's a big advantage. So we kind of saw that one coming as well. For the most part, it's been pretty on par with what we've seen all along, which is a good sign. We know now, like, with the larger population, kind of where we need to massage the abilities and the numbers.
Мы говорили о системе, где игроки дают баллы другим игрокам и где можно получить эпичную или легендарную медаль. Планируется ли это как-то показывать в игре? Будет ли где-то отмечено, что у меня, например, 10 легендарных и 20 эпичных медалей? Ну, вы понимаете.
Yeah, so we have some ideas for it. Like, there's an idea that we're chasing down. We're going all over the place. So, some sort of collection aspect where you can kind of keep your most prestigious cards. You know what I mean? Something like that. Like, we think they can be cool, and you should be excited when you get one. You should be excited when they go epic or legendary, and you should be able to show it off at some point. So, we have some more plans for it for sure.
Простой вопрос от комьюнити. Если сделать предзаказ игры, даст ли это автоматический доступ к бете или как-то увеличит шансы получить ее?
No. Negative.
Говоря о Симметрии, я узнал, что она может наносить урон через щит Райнхарда. Так и должно быть?
Yep. Okay. She can go through any barrier. Bastion, she's actually a really strong anti-Bastion.
Все герои Overwatch по-своему хороши. Можете рассказать о своих любимых героях и объяснить почему? Конечно, вы скажете, что Трейсер лучше всех, но назовите, скажем, топ-3.
Топ-3?
I love Tracer. I love Tracer not just necessarily because she's, you know, like we all feel like she's like our daughter or something like that. You know, she's a very, you know, she kind of represents Overwatch in a strange way. Like her pistols are awesome, and then her blink is amazing. The first time you recall as Tracer, I think, when you play a video game, is kind of just like, what? Like it feels awesome. Her pulse bomb is devastating, but it's not until you start to use them all in synergy and in harmony and start to get Reinhardt and you're blinking back and forth and he's flipping because he can't find you. It's more about that represents kind of the core values of what Overwatch is. So I love her. Genji is pretty amazing. I don't know if you guys had a chance to play Genji. His reflect is one of the funnest things in the game. It can reflect Zarya's Graviton Surge back at her so she gets sucked in. You can reflect McCree's stun. You can reflect sniper shots, which is amazing. Sometimes the sniper's shooting in a doorway, Widowmaker's like shooting at you, and maybe she has vision, so she knows you're going to come up. So she's just waiting to see your head, but she doesn't know that you have the reflect on. So when you come up and you're looking at her, she snipes herself in the head, which is pretty glorious.
Сейчас в бете наблюдается немного странная мета. Люди сначала играют нормально, а потом команда противника вдруг меняет героев, и у них оказывается, скажем, три Уинстона или Лусио. И эта перемена на танков может застать вас врасплох. Вы можете дать какой-то совет, как с этим бороться? Может быть, что-то подобное встречалось во внутренних турнирах Blizzard? Я знаю, вы проигрываете такие ситуации и способы их решения.
Usually, I mean, we have lots of anti-tank. I mean, I think Reaper, like Reaper versus Winston is brutal. It's super brutal. Same with Reinhardt or any of them. Symmetra's really good. Her beams, because they kind of freak out. Roadhog is really good. I know he's a tank too, but anything with big spread, Tracer's really good against them because you can get away and get them to chase you. And then the ult, because the ult is a little like chaotic, you can kind of dodge it a little bit. Bastion's really good. Just chewing through, especially against the monkey. I mean, he can jump behind you, but if you're coordinated with that, if you have a Reaper sitting back there, like, you know, come on, you try it. Yeah, but when they put up that dome, if he's, you know, holding down that left click, it'll nuke a shield, no problem.
Еще один короткий вопрос. Если купить игру для консоли, можно будет автоматически получить ее для ПК?
No, you do not.
Досадно. Говоря о скинах, сейчас они как в игре Heroes of the Storm, то есть один облик для всего героя. Планируются ли скины не на всего персонажа, а на отдельные его части, например, оружие или одежду?
The skins that we have right now are 100% the whole thing, including the weapon. So all the skins, like, for instance, if you look at the Strike Commander Morrison, his gun is a little different even too, so, but it's a head-to-toe and weapon thing.
Наверное, вы пока не знаете, как будут выходить новые герои после того, как выйдут первые 25.
21.
Хорошо, 21. Как они будут добавляться в игру? По одному или разом?
Yeah, this has come up a couple of times. For us, it's more about focusing on the 21. We want to release the game with 21, and wherever it goes from there, we don't know. Like, we don't have plans to just, okay, here's 1,000 more heroes. We think the game feels really good. We've known it because at one time we had 8 heroes, and then we added 2 more, and, you know, we didn't know the number was going to be 21 for ship, but it feels right for us, and it's less about... Here's all the different heroes you're going to get. It's more about, do we even need to do that? Is the community, is 21?
Давайте поговорим о киберспорте. Есть ли шанс увидеть Overwatch на следующем BlizzConе в качестве турнирной дисциплины? И расскажите поподробнее о киберспортивном аспекте и планируемых турнирах в будущем.
That would be awesome. I would be really excited to see. I think it would be really fun to watch. The esports things that we're looking at right now, we don't have a ton to share, but we do have plans and we're working through them right now. Ultimately, we want to focus because it's a little more dynamic in terms of the movement than like CSGO is awesome, like very tactical and you can, but we're going up and down and left and right and rewinding through time and doing all this stuff. So we need to work on making sure it's really watchable. That's kind of our big focus right now. And we're doing some small things like a private match. If you go in as an observer, you can actually do things where you can do the floating cam and actually lock onto the hero and just follow them around just from a static cam, and that actually makes it pretty watchable. And then you can actually switch that to another hero and then actually go into their third person, where maybe people that have motion sickness don't get that as much. So we have plans, and like the thing that's in private match is like our first step, but we love esports. If next year we were lucky enough for there to be some competition, that'd be awesome.
Еще один вопрос о соревновательной части игры, в частности, о наблюдении за игрой с точки зрения зрителя. Планируете ли вы добавить kill feed, оповещение, какой герой умер и от чего?
Yeah, that's the other one that I did that people can hate me for. It's fine. It's totally fine.
God.
The kill feed, like, we are open to the idea, but we want to, like, so we have a lot of feedback. Like, oh, the UI is too cluttered, or the game's... But then there's a request for a kill feed, and maybe they want portraits for the teammates who are, like, the what we want to do is we want to keep everything in the world as much as possible. I feel like... the death timer that's around the corner from your teammate, or the fact that they're in combat, meaning they flash orange, is enough information to help. That's actually valuable, because around that corner, your friend is in a fight, which that doesn't necessarily give you. I'm not a giant fan of looking in the corner to get that information. We're open to the idea. It's just we haven't seen enough feedback right now to like just say, okay, we got to put it in there. I think there's a lot of people that are super into it, but from the beta feedback that we have, it isn't this overwhelming amount for us.
И в завершении интервью, не могли бы вы сказать несколько слов, особенно тем, у кого еще нет беты?
Beta? Well, you know what? We are going to do stress test weekend coming up. We're going to do a stress test weekend, I think, before the end of the year, which means we're going to open it up to a very large number. And I think that the idea there is so that we can start to test the servers on our way to launch. Launch is in spring 2016, so it's coming up pretty quickly. The wait isn't too long. A few stress test weekends, people will get to play more.
Thank you.
Awesome.